Questions 4 through 6 pertain to this titration curve. A weak monoprotic acid is titrated with a strong base, KOH. A titration curve typically has the volume of the titrant, usually a strong base, on the x-axis, and the resulting pH on the y-axis. There's an equivalence point on the graph where all of the starting solution has been neutralized by the titrant. So here we started with an acid, and it's the point where you've added enough base to neutralize the acid. You can usually eyeball this point. It's where the concavity of the graph changes. So question 4. The point at which the moles of the added strong base are equal to the moles of the weak acid initially present. Okay, that is C. That's what we were just talking about. You can see where the concavity of the graph changes. This is the equivalence point. And you can see on the graph, it corresponds with about 100 milliliters of this 0.1000 molar KOH added. Question 5. The point at which the pH is closest to that of the strong base being added. Okay, this is going to be point E. Notice we are past the equivalence point, where all the acid has been neutralized. Past that point, more and more base is being added, more and more of that KOH. So you can see the pH is increasing and increasing until it starts to level off. So you can see it's still changing at point D, so D is not right. That's not quite at the pH of the titrant. But by point E, the curve is changing less and less, and it's closer to a plateau. So E is the best answer. Question 6. The point at which the concentrations of the weak acid and its conjugate base are approximately equal. So here you need to know a little detail about titration curves. For monoprotic acids, the point halfway between the start of the curve and the equivalence point is significant. That's where the concentrations of the acid and its conjugate base are equal. We found earlier the equivalence point was C when you add 100 milliliters of KOH. So halfway is 50 milliliters, which corresponds to point B on the graph. So the answer is B. Be sure to subscribe to Socratica so you don't miss our next video, which will cover questions 7 through 9 of the 2008 Chemistry AP. If you found this video helpful, please like it and share it with your friends. And if you're really enjoying all the videos we make at Socratica, we'd love it if you would consider becoming our patron on Patreon. By making a small donation every month, you'll help us make more of the high-quality educational videos for everyone to enjoy. Thank you.